Here's my take on a little bit of a classic cheat for getting your bass and your kick to sit together in a mix. First, let's take a listen to the kick and the bass together. I actually have two kick tracks here, and I have them routed to a kick aux. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a plug-in on the bass aux, or the bass bus here. Which there, it could go directly on the bass track. In this case, I only have one bass track. Usually, you might only have one bass track. This plugin is called TDR Nova. This is a dynamic EQ, and there are a couple plugins that you can use to do this. This one I find has a couple of features that other plugins don't. Other more expensive and not free plugins. So the first thing that we're going to do is where you have this little key here, this is a sidechain input, and we are going to set the sidechain input to be the kick drum. Big surprise. And since I already have that bust to its own aux track, it's ready to go for me. Now, this is on the bass track, but what we're going to listen to is the kick. We're going to listen to the low end of the kick and how it speaks through the bass track. I'm going to set this to external sidechain, and I'm going to set the analyzer to the sidechain. So now we're seeing the kick. I'm going to do one more thing, and I'm going to set this, instead of stereo, we are going to process the sum. What that means is, this is like an MS dynamic EQ, so we are only going to address the information that is common to the left and right channels, or the center information, which is usually where your kick drum and your bass are fighting for low frequencies. Now I'm going to add a low shelf, and to make it dynamic, hit this threshold button, give it a pretty high ratio, all the way up, and just start bringing down that threshold. If you're listening on headphones, you can probably already hear the low end of the kick drum starting to bloom. Could bring the frequency up a bit. Now we don't need to hit this very hard. Don't want to take all the bass out of the bass, but we can speed up the attack and actually slow down the release so that it breathes with the kick drum, because you don't want to cut off the decay of the low end of the kick drum. Let's see what that sounds like without. It's definitely cleaner, and you can feel that bass drum in your chest a little bit. Well, we're wearing headphones, but I can imagine that I feel it in my chest. My ears, chest, the chest of my mind.